Hey, guys, do you know what it's like to be a
dick? Rescue heroes right in there. That's right. Oh, hi. Hey, it's Dave. And you know me, but you don't know me. And you know this guy. This is my dog, Dave. They can be firefighters, police officers, Coast Guard guys, men.
So, you failed to live up to his expectations. How predictable.
Look at this, Charlie. This looks like the work.
The Great Bet.
Well, they must be getting close now. Yeah.
Heard of the Urban Search and Rescue Team. Oh, these guys are dicked. If there's an earthquake or hurricane or earthquake or dick or earthquake or maybe a building collapses and they got these are the Don Shellhammer is that you call. He's one of the main guys with the California Task Force. Don, tell me some of the things you do and some of the neat tools that you use to do it.
Well, basically, this engine just goes right where the tracks are laid out.
Wherever they go,
that's where we're going to go.
Okay, how about the controls?
Basically, it's all set up where you go forward, you go backwards, and go fast or stop. That's all there is to it.
Well, we respond out to any type of incident that involves large-scale collapses, floods, earthquakes, hurricanes, anything like that. And then we take out our specialized equipment, and we're able to extricate people out of those areas where they could be trapped.
Can you show us how it works?
You bet.
Okay, come on.
Start off with the crowbar, and a crowbar is just like any almost digging bar that we have at your basic hardware store. And we utilize that to go ahead and raise up, again, heavy things that we just normally couldn't lift up.
The guys that put the wood in to keep it propped up are called Neckerbirds. Big red firefighter, you know, another kind of fighter. You hear, in fact, rescuers, a hero. Firefighter almost rescues all day.
Here he is.
How do you do, sir? Captain Mike Bongers of the North County Fire Department, a real-life firefighting rescue hero. It's Dave reporting for duty, sir. I want to learn all about being a firefighting rescue hero.
All righty.
What's the most important thing a firefighting rescue hero has to remember?
Well, the most important thing is you need to remember coming.
That's for sure. But other than that?
Other than that, Dave, the most important thing is to remember that we have to be ready to come at a moment's notice.
My own turnout coat.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you, sir. Yeah, this is great. One heck of a fire truck. Oh, look at this.
All right.
These are the tools, right?
Right. These are the tools we talked about.
These are the tools.
Right. These are the tools.
The tools.
These are the tools.
Tools.
Tools. Remember I told you the tools we use to get cars open that have been in wrecks? The first tool here is, our big scissors here, our hydraulic scissor.
Big hydraulic scissors.
Tool.
Tool. Tool.
Hydraulic scissor.
Wow.
Tool.
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 Hydraulic scissor.
Hydraulic scissors.
Wow. Real strong. Our third tool is our first tool.
Hydraulic scissors.
You got it. You got it.
We'll get right on it. The power unit. These hose are used to pump the hydraulic deck.
Like, oh, she's gonna blow. Slice, slice. Where that smoke's coming from, it could be very dangerous. Oh, it could be very dangerous.
Take her away.
Gotta get the hose. Now I got the hose.
My name is Tammy, and I'm a paramedic. Part of my job is a car crash.